Thank you for that introduction. Yes, we have an interesting situation today. Our energy system is outdated. It's all about combusting oil and coal, and we produce a lot of carbon dioxide. So we have to change. We have to change to renewable energy. At the way to renewable energy, there's one big block on the road. That's storage. And so we have to understand what's going on in our world. Now, the first thing I want to tell you is that photovoltaic is a very unique thing if you look how fast this technology is growing. Between two major lines, there is a factor of 10. This means crossing a new line 10 times as much photovoltaics. We started in the early 90s. There, at that time, the United States was the leading country in PV installations. The whole world had about 100 megawatt. Then the Japanese came in. They had a strong program. It was growing and growing. And in the beginning of the 21st century, Germany started really fast growing. And since then, we have now covered two times the line. And I have learned yesterday that we now have covered the next line. We are now beyond the 100 gigawatt hours of electricity coming from photovoltaics. That is a great thing. And we have to look into the future, what will go on. I'm not quite sure if the line is always that steep as it is now, but maybe we have an annual growth of 30%. That is not unusual in economics. Then, within the next decade, we will see that our global demand could be solved by photovoltaics. Now, look again. Today, in our world, 0.5% of the electricity is coming out of photovoltaics. That seems to be a real small thing, but I have an even smaller number for you. It is 0.003. This was 1998. And if that goes on, in the year 2028, 15 years from now, we will have 50%, half of our energy, coming from photovoltaics. That's great. Now, the interesting thing is that it's not only a thing that happens in Germany. Italy was the country with the most installations in 2011. India has the largest photovoltaic site of the world. Of course, Germany has most of the rooftops with solar. China has most of the production capacity, and United States have the highest efficiency in labs. That means that it's a global bright day for our photovoltaics. But there is a problem. We have a problem at night. We have to solve that. We have to solve that problem, and we have to understand that problem. Then we can solve it. Now, what I show you here is that's the demand of electricity in Germany. Other countries are quite similar. In the early morning and the night, the demand is low. And then the sun rises, people wake up by new computers I've learned, and then the demand rises and peaks at lunchtime. And then it goes slowly down in the evening, one or the other is going to bed. Now, to close that gap, conventional power was always produced in such an amount that it exactly matched that. That is great, but you need this storage in the way of coal and gas and so on. Now, sun comes in. If sun comes in, it comes always during the day. And it releases the situation. We don't need so much energy at the daytime, so we don't have to store during night for the day, but we do in the moment, and now more and more sun is coming in within the next years. What will go on? There will still be no energy in the night, but at the day we'll have a lot of energy. And we have even more energy than we can use, so we have to waste that. But if the growth is going on, we have so much energy that wasting that energy is not a good idea, and we should store that energy and use it at night time. That's the basic idea. Now, storage is available in Germany. Our storage capacity is about half an hour. That's all, not more. Okay, so what we need is storage. And now we have to build a check card and go into what do we really need. We need low price for the kilowatt hour storage capacity. The reason is otherwise it's not economic, and if it's not economic, it won't work. The next thing is we need high efficiency, because we produce all this electricity with quite expensive things like photovoltaic or wind turbines. And we want a small footprint. All this change to renewable is about environment-friendly stuff. So our storage should also be environmentally friendly. So first guess, battery. Great thing, we use it every day. But the low price thing is not here. Battery is about $200 per kilowatt hour. And they are already in high scale produced. Every car has this battery, so there won't be a big change in the future. Small footprint is also not here. Reason, we need metals. During mining, we have problems with the environment. During disposal, we have problems with the environment. So batteries are difficult. They have one thing, and it's clear, that is high efficiency. They have about something like 90%. That's great, but two showstoppers. Then there is an interesting idea in Germany that says we take our electricity and make gas. Gas, natural gas, is well known. We have a big infrastructure. We have storage systems. So why don't make gas from our electricity? Now, the price is low because the infrastructure is already here. The point is the efficiency. We have to convert the electricity into hydrogen. Then we have to convert the hydrogen into methane. And then we have to convert that back to power, electricity. And only 25% are here and 75% are lost, so it's a new way to waste energy. Now, yes, it's really a great way to do that. Small footprint, that's true. Yeah, okay. So there's one solution that is well known, that is pumped hydro. The idea is very simple. We take water, use an electrical pump, and pump it up the hill. And then, if we need the energy, we release the water through a turbine, and the energy is coming back to us. That's great. It's so low price that 99% of all storage systems in the world are pumped hydro. So that seems to be interesting. It has high efficiency, about 80%, so the energy is really coming back that we put in there. There's one problem. It's not a small footprint. Usually, we have an uphill basin, and that is usually the area where people in dense populated areas want to make holiday. So we can't flood it. Otherwise, the communities don't like it. So, no, that doesn't work. Okay, now come to my new idea. The idea is very simple. Instead of pumping the water uphill, we pump the water below the hill and lift the hill. And the question is, does this really make sense? Hydraulic hydro storage. Now, how to build something like that? So look into the ground. In the ground, there is always rock material. And now we look into that, and we dig down a shaft, and then we dig we drill two tunnel systems, and then we drill a lot of holes into the surface, and these holes are necessary to guide our sawing strings, and the sawing strings are cutting the rock, as it is always done in a quarry where you are used to this cut it granite or other things. And then you can lift it. You don't have to forget the O-ring, otherwise it won't leak. That's not a good idea. So now we can lift it. Okay. To understand that, and now comes really late evening, a very difficult part, is how does this really work? And does it work out cheap? And the point is, if I take a cylinder with a radius, and the height of the cylinder is just the diameter, so 2 times the radius, then I can lift it up to R. That means I can't lift it higher, otherwise it gets stuck. That's not a good idea with a mountain. We don't do that. So the final thing is now we have to calculate. If you remember some stuff from math, it is for math, the volume is something like r to the third power, and for height is r. So combining that, we can calculate the storage capacity. The energy is proportional to our gravity, to the mass, and to the height I move it. Okay, that's the three things. Now, we have to introduce that. That's very simple in our quick PowerPoint. And now we see, with some more calculations, it's to the fourth power. And if we build it, then the interesting thing is, building is not to the fourth power. Building is only about talking about the surface. We have to cut the surface. And that is second power. Combining that means that the cost of the kilowatt hour storage capacity is going 1 by r squared. Okay, this was a little bit hard stuff for this evening. So I say it now in a fairly simple sentence. Double the radius, and the price goes down to a quarter. That's the idea. Double the radius, price goes down. That's unique. That's really unique. Now, the point is, can we build something with this height? Now, the 80 meter here, it's really wonderful in the ocean. It's 80 meter, absolutely vertical. Over there, 300 meter vertical. That works with rock in nature. But that's not the end. Going to another place, there's a waterfall, and waterfalls like to fall vertical. And so it's 1,000 meter vertical. Then the reason why nature doesn't show us too often this type, it doesn't cut rocks in that way. That's the reason. So we have to cut it. We have to seal it. Sealing, yes, we have to cover it with some geomembrane and some plastic, and we have to put some metals there that the O-rings are sliding smooth, like technology is. And we can look into that, and we can see that if we have these O-rings, we have not only one O-ring, we have a lot of O-rings, and every of this O-ring keeps 10 bar. 10 bars is the pressure in the wire of a truck. That's absolutely standard in technology. That's not a big deal. And we have to operate it. Now, what we're doing is we collect the electricity from overproduction. This electricity goes into the ground, and we use our pump. The pump is pressurizing the water beneath, and now it is lifting the rock. And it's lifting and lifting, and more energy is going into this rock. And now in the evening, and the moon is coming, which doesn't happen here, then we can play back the electricity. 80% is coming back to the grid, and we can use it when we need it. So that means we have now an interesting way to store energy, and now the question is always, is there a business? Yes, there is a business model. The business model works very simple. Buy cheap. Buy cheap means during daytime, if there is overproduction, cheap electricity is there. If there is overproduction of wind energy, cheap wind energy is there. Then you have to wait until the production of power by photovoltaic or wind is below the need. Then people are asking for power, and they will pay you more than you had to buy. So that is buy cheap, sell expensive. Now, the next thing is storing energy will be a big business. Today it is not, because we have 0.5% photovoltaics. That's not a big business. What happens is here, for example, this 500 meter rock, if it is one time lifted, it has that much energy in there that if you sell that energy, you earn $160 million. That is the amount of energy in this rock. And you can lift it many times. And every time you earn that money, until you have earned that much money as you had to rent for building that. So now we have our checklist again. Low price per kilowatt hour. Yes. Why? Because we have a 1/R rule that tells us we can go down to something like a few dollars per kilowatt hour storage capacity, 100 times less than batteries. High efficiency. Of course, because we have the same technology as pumped hydro and they have 80%, so it is definitely the best efficiency we can have. Small footprint. We don't generate radioactivity or chemical spills or metals. No, we don't generate any waste because the rock was always there and will stay there. We don't move as far away from there. Okay, small footprint. Now, today we see that photovoltaic is coming in, wind power is coming in, and if we can combine this renewable energy with storage, we can produce clean and sustainable energy in the future. Thank you for your attention.